Hi friends, welcome to the new series Angular Hero to Superhero. If you are a beginner trying to learn Angular, there is another series Angular Zero to Hero in which I have explained all the basic concepts. You can find the link in the description. In this Angular series Hero to Superhero, I am focusing on advanced concepts. In this video, I am going to explain you why we need to choose SCSS option while creating an Angular application using CLI. Let's start. While creating an Angular application using CLI, we can see an option to choose the CSS preprocessor. What is a CSS preprocessor? A CSS preprocessor is a tool used to extend the basic functionality of default vanilla CSS through its own scripting language. However, browsers can only understand native vanilla CSS code and will be unable to interpret the CSS preprocessor syntax. Therefore, preprocessor syntax needs to be first compiled into native CSS syntax, which can then be interpreted by the browsers. Different preprocessors have their own unique syntaxes, but all of them are compiled to the same native CSS code. Here, first option is CSS. This is not a preprocessor. This is plain vanilla CSS. Most of the people who don't know the advantages of SASS always go for this option. Next one is SCSS. This is my preferred choice, and I am going to explain you why I always choose this option. SCSS means Sassy CSS. It almost has the syntax of CSS, but it supports all SASS features like nested CSS, variables, mixins, inheritance, etc. And the next one is SASS. SASS means syntactically awesome style sheets. This is the most popular preprocessor which supports all the features I explained above. But the disadvantages of this option is SASS follows indentation syntax like Python. So if you are not following the proper indentation, it may not work. Also, SCSS has curly braces and semicolons, just like plain CSS. So it is easy to read and maintain when compared to SASS. That is why SCSS is preferred over SASS. Next one is LESS. LESS means linear style sheets. This is also similar to SASS, but it does not support functions and it uses at symbols to declare variables. This may cause confusion with at media and at keyframes. So I will not prefer this option. And the last one is stylus. I haven't used stylus so far, but I heard stylus is also a good option. It supports all SASS features. Also, I heard it has many useful and powerful built-in functions. If any of you have used stylus, please post the advantages and disadvantages of stylus in the comment section. Now let me talk about few of the SASS features. There are many. We need to cover that in a separate series. For now, let me explain a couple of them quickly. Assume I have a nested divs like this. If I want to target this class in plain CSS, I need to use it like this. But in SASS, I can use nested CSS. Like this. If I have another div parallel to class 4, in CSS, I need to mention all previous classes and this one. But in SASS, I can easily put the new class parallel to this. When compared to normal CSS, SASS is more easy to read and maintain. Let's see another one. Assume I have a class blue box in which I have all these properties, and a red box. In this, the only change is going to be the background color. In normal CSS, we need to repeat all the CSS codes. But in SASS, we can have a common class in which we can keep all the common properties and we can use the @extend keyword to inherit these properties like this. So instead of repeating all these again, we can reuse the codes. Coming back to the 5 options, as I'm not familiar with stylus, I'll not go for that. And I have already explained why I will not go for LESS and SASS. So the remaining options are CSS and SCSS. I already told most of the people who are not familiar with SASS features prefer to choose CSS option. But I will say, even though you are not familiar with SASS features, you should choose SCSS. Because I have showed you SCSS file supports CSS syntaxes. So you can write plain CSS in this. And you can slowly learn the features of SASS one by one and use it in your application in longer run. But if you choose CSS option, it will not support SASS syntax. So in future, if there is a requirement to use SASS in your application, you need to either use the Angular schematic command to migrate, or you will have to add the schematics in AngularJSON and then manually rename all the CSS files to SCSS. This is going to be an additional overhead. That is why I am saying, even if you are not familiar with SASS, you can choose SCSS as the option when you create a new application. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.